Last night, I did something that I've wanted to do ever since I was a little girl. I closed my eyes, spun the globe, and it landed on a random country. My finger was in South Korea. Within the next 1 hour, we'd booked flights to South Korea. We're going there next month, and I just can't wait. Now, this is all very exciting to someone who boarded her first flight at the age of 18. I remember exploring the chaotic bylanes of Singapore as a solo traveler in my teens. 72 countries later, the act of booking a flight to a new destination still puts a huge smile on my face every single time.
Both of us are constantly questioned about traveling the world 365 days a year, and more importantly, about sustaining ourselves. You won't believe the kind of things we get to hear, from being quizzed about our supposed ancestral property to being told that we are rich brats. We've heard it all. Now, unfortunately, or rather fortunately, none of that is true. We are hoping that our talk today will answer some of your questions. We'd like to give you an insight into what we like calling the art of possible by breaking down the idea of traveling the world and being location-independent entrepreneurs into a few easy steps. Now, the first step is the most obvious one, and yet most people fail to make past this one. In order to achieve the life you dream of, you need to visualize it clearly. But just visualizing it is not enough. You need to gather the courage to take a leap of faith and make your dreams a reality. You see, life is an amalgamation of moments. We educate ourselves, we get jobs, and we gradually slip into oblivion. The oblivion of ticking things off a checklist, whether that be buying a house, collecting cars, getting married, or producing babies. Despite having nascent dreams, we continue to go through our lives, grumbling about our jobs, but turning up at office every day to pay for that bigger car or a better house. We know something's not quite right, and yet we go through routine life. Why? Because we are averse to breaking the shackles of stability and convention. Now that is what needs to change. You need to question convention and do what makes you feel happy. You need to close your eyes and take a huge leap of faith. Of course, this isn't easy. Far from it. Take our example. Till 2 years ago, we were well settled in London. I was working a 9-to-5 job and Savi was completing her PhD. By the time we were 30, we had achieved everything we set out to achieve by the time, both education and job-wise. We had well-paying jobs and a traditionally secure future ahead of us. We'd spent our teenage years backpacking in Asia. We loved traveling all the time. But now that we were in London, we would take frequent trips to Europe, Africa, and even America sometimes. There was always this constant nagging feeling that those 4 days in Paris were not enough. We needed 4 weeks, or rather 4 months. So, we decided to save money to travel long-term. And one fine day, we quit our jobs, and with that, our life in London. I will not lie, it was scary to hand in that resignation letter. Even scarier to pack everything we own. But it was also exciting, very exciting. Most importantly, we were sure we wanted to do this, and were comfortable taking that huge leap of faith. After all, you get one life, and both of us wanted to enjoy every single sumptuous second of it. Khalil Gibran words it beautifully. They deem me mad because I will not sell my days for gold, and I deem them mad because they think my days have a price. In order to enjoy that one life you get, you need to get out of your comfort zone. You need to question the notion of reality that is fed to you, and you need to go where your dreams take you. Acting on your dreams is the only way of translating them into reality.
This brings me to the second part of this entire journey of traveling. You've broken free of the shackles of convention. You've visualized your dreams. Now, it's time to make that idyllic lifestyle on the road a sustainable one. Despite what online memes and fancy-looking inspirational quotes might tell you, booking a one-way ticket, getting a tan, and falling in love is bad advice. In fact, it often results in heartbreaks and bankruptcy. You need to start exploiting your skill set, whatever that might be, to earn an income on the road. It's important to dream, but it's even more essential to make the effort and put the effort to make those dreams a reality. Irrespective of whether you're a musician, a graphic artist, an engineer, or a doctor, there are lots of location-independent jobs and freelance gigs that you could take up on the road. For the two of us, the choice was clear. We wanted to put my background in literature and creative writing, Vid's passion for photography, and our shared interest in traveling the world towards creating travel-related content, content that we were proud of. That's how Bruce Passports was born. We worked 20-hour days to set up a website from scratch. We did everything ourselves, and then we worked hundreds of thousands of hours, and we continue to do that, to garner a reading on social media and on our website. It's been a steep learning curve, and we've learned so many lessons along the way. We've learned that establishing a location-independent business online is not as easy as we originally anticipated. We've also learned that sustaining that business takes rigorous motivation and discipline. Bruce Passports is 4 years old today, and right now, the two of us spend more time working on it than we used to in our old jobs. Just to give you an example, I wrote 120,000 words for my PhD thesis over a period of 4 years. In the first 18 months at Bruce Passports alone, I had written more content than that for our website. Thank you. People love telling us how lucky we are because we get to travel the world. But the fact of the matter is, the harder you work, the luckier you get. The good thing, thank you. The good thing is that if your work fuels your passion, it doesn't feel like work at all. Setting up an online platform and watching it flower in front of our eyes is such an exhilarating feeling. It makes us happy every single day. Bruce Passports started with one reader, my mom, obviously, who's sitting right there. And today it has over 2 million readers. Having this virtual family just excites us to no end, and we bump into them across the globe, wherever we go. Of course, it's not all hunky-dory. As most of you would know, the online world can be quite the killjoy. There are digital trolls and naysayers by the dozen. But here's the thing. Don't let them get to you. Treat every troll and naysayer as a reminder of the fact that it's impossible to please everybody with the decisions you make in life. Let that be a reminder to stick to your gut instinct and follow your passion single-mindedly. Be unshakable in your convictions and celebrate your individuality, because that is what will take you places. Places such as national dailies, magazines, and the TED stage. Now, this unique take on trolling, I know it's not a very popular opinion, but I feel trolling is very empowering. And this unique take on trolling brings me to our third and most important point of traveling the world: perspective. Everything depends on perspective.
You see, when you travel all the time, there'll always be problems. There'll be that faulty ATM, dingy hotel rooms, language barriers, and mobile networks that just don't work. But there will also be incredible destinations, panoramas that will blow your socks off, and complete strangers that will greet you with the biggest smiles. Always look at the glass half full. The way we look at the world determines what we see. Book a ticket, accept new places with eyes wide with wonder, surrender to the idiosyncrasies, and believe in the magic of travel. That's when you'll find it.
Most importantly though, never lose sight of why you started this journey in the first place. If you're a digital entrepreneur or even a social media enthusiast, you would know how addictive social media can get. Did you know that interacting on social media, getting likes on Facebook or comments on Instagram, secretes dopamine and serotonin in the brain? Which is exactly what happens when you binge on addictive substances like tobacco or alcohol or confectionery for that matter. Now, the solution isn't to cut it out altogether, because as a marketing tool, social media is unparalleled for digital entrepreneurs. Instead, you should seek to conquer it, maintain a certain distance from it, and use it to your advantage. If you're a Harry Potter fan, you've probably heard my favorite quote already. It's the quality of one's conviction that determines success, not the number of followers. The thing is, we always fuss over likes and numbers. Instead of that, we should be using our time on the road to dwell on things that are most important to us. For the two of us, that's spending precious time with our friends and family. In fact, my favorite thing about traveling the world is to be able to live mindfully and spend every hour of every day with the boy I love. It is the freedom. It is the freedom of being able to listen to the rhythm of my body instead of those pesky things called office schedules or alarm clocks. It is the liberty of being able to appreciate the smaller things in life. And that could be the season's first snowfall, it could be a starry sky, or it could even be something as simple as a home-cooked meal. That's why I tell people, follow your heart. It will take you places, places that you hadn't even dreamed about, but places that exist. For the two of us, that place is an Indonesian beach where we stand barefoot as the wind plays with our hair. Looking back at life with satisfaction and a huge smile. The second you discover that place is when you'll know happiness, true and pure happiness. Thank you.
Thank you.